Hey guys, today we are showing you how to create another stylus transition between scenes. It is often called the eye zoom transition, and it starts with a shadow or reflection in the eye of the beholder. First things first, let's add a video with an eye. You can find them on stock video websites, but if you want to use your own footage, remember that it's crucial for the eye to remain still. Ideally, you should avoid blinking too. Make a double click on the video and add an ellipse to the scene. Place it over the pupil. The pupil must be covered completely, and it's alright if the ellipse touches the eyelid a bit. We'll fix it later. Now choose ellipse style number 3, solid color without borders, and paint it black. Make a double click on the ellipse and add the Gaussian blur filter. Go to the Properties window and find Blur Levels. Apply the value of 10 here. Then, find the Extend the Boundaries parameter and switch to True. Now add another ellipse. And this time, try to stay close to the eye shape. Again, paint the ellipse black and select Inverted Mask from the Blending Modes menu. It's located on the left-hand side of the timeline. Find the fade-in effect . Add it to the scene and go back to the tab with the first ellipse. Select the first ellipse on the timeline with the mouse button and choose Mask from the Blending Modes menu. Go to the Video Effects section at the top, proceed to Transforms and apply the effect named Crop. Place the cursor at the beginning of the effect. Switch the parameter change mode to Linear Parameter Change along a trajectory. Now place the cursor at the end of the fade-in effect we added earlier. Click the Crop Tools button. You will see a cropping frame on the scene. Meanwhile, on the timeline, there is a trajectory to help you adjust the cropping borders. Your goal is to keep the cropping frame inside the pupil. Find the Cropped Borders menu and use the icon on the right-hand side. From the drop-down menu, select Set Width according to parent aspect ratio. Place the cursor at the end of the crop effect on the timeline. Go back to the Cropped Borders menu and use the same icon. From the drop-down menu, select Set Same Borders as previous point has. Use the Apply Effect button. Go back to the tab with the video. Place the cursor at the beginning of the crop effect and the ellipse layer on the timeline. Now open the very first tab. Add the second video and place it on the timeline starting from the cursor position. Make sure it's one layer below the first video with the eye. Preview to see the result. We're hoping that you like this tutorial. Let us know what other effects you'd like to learn on our channel. Cheers!